हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम। माय नेम इज़ आबिद। टुडे विल डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ द रॉल्ट एक्ट। सो प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस इलस्ट्रेटली अबाउट द टॉपिक ऑफ द आइडिया ऑफ द सत्याग्रह, आर यू कैन से सिंपली सत्याग्रह। बट इन दिस वीडियो, इन दिस लेक्चर, विल डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ रॉल्ट एक्ट, एम्बोल्डेनेड विद द सक्सेस। गांधी जी इन 1919 डिसाइडेड टू लॉन्च ए नेशनल वाइड सत्याग्रह अगेंस्ट द प्रपोज्ड रॉल्ट एक्ट 1999। सो द प्रीवियस लास्ट वीडियो आई हैव डिस्कस इलस्ट्रेटली व्हाट वाज द रॉल्ट एक्ट। इट वाज द लॉ विच मेड बाय द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट एंड इन विच वी फाउंड दैट नो एनी क्राइम आर नो एनी विक्टम्स यू विल बी डिटेंशन ऑफ द 2 ईयर्स एंड इन विच यू फाउंड दैट नो वकील नो दलील एंड नो एनी क्राइम ड्यू टू दिस एंड सिंपली यू विल बी डिटेंशन फॉर ए टू ईयर्स। दिस एक्ट हैड बीन हॉरडली passed through the imperial legislative council despite the united opposition of the Indian members. So it has been passed imperial legislative council, in which we found that there was no any Indian members. It gave the government enormous powers to repress political activities and allowed detention of political prisoners without trial for 2 years. So this law had made for the people that or you can say it was made enormous power to the repress political activities and allowed detention of political prisoners without trial for 2 years. Mahatma Gandhiji wanted non-violent civil disobedience against such unjust laws, which would start with a hartal on 6th April. So for the opposition of this law, or you can see for this acts, Gandhiji started hartal on 6th April. So realized were organized in various cities. Workers went on strikes in railway workshop and shop, closed down, alarmed by the popular upsurge, and secured that lines of the communication such as the railways and telegraph would be disrupted. The British administration decided to clamp down on the nationalists. So these all the system had been hanged at the time, and the British government, or again the British administration, decided to clamp down on the nationalists. Local leaders were picked up from the Amritsar, and Mahatma Gandhi was barred from entering Delhi. On 10th April, the police in Amritsar fired upon a peaceful procession, provoking widespread attacks on the banks, post offices and railway station. Martial law was imposed, and General Dyle took command. So in the previous last video, inshallah, in future I will be discuss on the topic of the Jallianwala Bagh, in which we will find that how General Dyle ordered to fire the people, and how many people have been died at that time. So on 13 April, the famous Jallianwala Bagh incident took place. So guys, Jallianwala Bagh, 13 April 1919, took place. On that day, a large crowd gathering in the enclosed ground of Jallianwala Bagh. So large crowd was gathered there. So guys, some came to protest against the government's new repressive measures. Others had come to attend the annual Baisakhi fair. So the common people don't know. That's why, because they have come there attend or the celebrate their annual festival of the Baisakhi, or the harvest of the crops. This day they are celebrating there, but some leaders have also come there, and due to this cause, being from outside the city, many villagers were unaware of the martial law that happened being imposed. And there the common people don't know that what is the martial law, or you can say Rault Act, and they had also come to celebrate the Baisakhi. Dire General Dyer entered the area, blockaded the exit points and opened fire on the crowd, killing hundreds. So guys, if you will go in Amritsar, where we will found the Jallianwala Bagh, in which there is the only one gate, and inside of the gate will found one well, and General Dyer had closed the main gate, and there is too much long walls through which no one can be fly or will be all will be fly from the walls or jump from the walls. So when General Dyer ordered to fire the people, some people, hundreds of the people had been died there, and that's why, because there was no any defense area where they will protect themselves, and there was a well. Some people jumped in well, and some people have taken shooted by the bullet. His objects, as he declared later, was to produce a moral effect, to create in the minds of the satyagrahis a feeling of the terror and away. So we are in satyagraha, in which Gandhiji has developed truth and search of the truth, and emphasize them that we are against the truth, truth, we have no need to worry about it. And as the news of the Jallianwala Bagh separated, crowd took to the streets in many North Indian towns. There were strikes, clashes with the police, and attacks on the government buildings. And when this news has separated throughout the country, so many areas, like you will find that North India towns, and also strikes, clashes, and attacks of the public, police, and the government buildings, the government respond with the brutal repression, seeking to humiliate and terrorize people. Satyagrahis were forced to rub their nose on the grounds, crawl on the streets, and don't salam, salute to all sahibs. People were forced, and village around the Gujranwala in Punjab, now in Pakistan, were bombed, seeing violence separate. Mahatma Gandhiji called off the movement. So guys, where we found that Jallianwala Bagh, when the Jallianwala Bagh incident took place, and at that time that hundreds of the people had been killed, for this anger, the whole of the nation people, they have protest against the British government. They have fired the government buildings. They have crevel on the streets, and inspired the people that we have no need to salute of to the side, to the Ferengi, to the British government. And while the Rowlatt Act Satyagraha had been wide separate movement, and due to this cause, Gandhiji called off this movement. This is called the Satyagraha movement. While the Rowlatt Act Satyagraha had been a wide separate movement, it was still limited mostly to city and towns. And when the Rowlatt Act has been made for the opposition of this act, this movement was not been a wide separate movement. It was still limited mostly to cities and towns, but Mahatma Gandhiji now felt the need to launch a more broader based movement on the Indian. And but Gandhiji found that we have need to protest throughout the country against this act. But he was certain that no such movement could be organized without being the Hindus and Muslims closer together. So Gandhiji, firstly, who think that we have need to unite the people of the Muslim and Hindus on one way of doing this, he felt was take up the Khilafat issue. The First World War had ended with the defeat of the Empire of the Ottoman Turkey, and the First World War, you have found the previous last video that we have discussed illustratively what was the main cause of the First World War, and how the Balkans was under the control of the Ottoman Empire. And when Ottoman Empire disintegrate and defeat in First World War, the whole of the world movement had been, and the people and the Khilafat issue had been exist, and there were no rumors that a harsh peace treaty was going to be imposed on the Ottoman Empire. The spiritual head of the Islamic world, the Khilafia, to defend the Khilafia Imperial Temporal Powers. A Khilafia Khilafat Committee was formed in March 1999, when the Ottoman Empire defeated in the First World War, and the whole of the people believed on that's why, because this was belong to the Islamic Road Khilafah, and the movement for this, the new committee was formed in Bombay in March 1999. A young generation of Muslim leaders like the brothers Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali began discussing with Mahatma Gandhiji about the possibility of the unite mass action on the issue. Gandhiji saw this is an opportunity to bring Muslim under the umbrella of a unified national movement. At the Calcutta session of the Congress in September 1920, he convinced other leaders of the need to start a non-cooperation movement in support of the Khilafat as well as for the Swaraj. So simply Swaraj means the complete independence, I think. So 1929, this slogan had been given by the Tilak or anybody else. Khilafat, Gandhiji found that firstly we have need to unite, and the cause has been exist at that time. The cause was that Khilafah, or you can say the defeat of the Ottoman Empire. Turkey had been declined, and for the protection all the people of the world, they feel that we have need to defend the Khilafah. And Gandhiji also feel in India that this is the good opportunity that how we can unite the people and start a non-cooperation movement, support of Khilafat as well as for Swaraj. So he convinced the people, other leaders, of the need to start a non-cooperation, and in the end the Gandhiji has start non-cooperation movement with the support of the Muslims and the Hindus and overall community of the country. In the end,